5.
Going for it.
Go!
Let's just find the best ice and snow we can.
Sure.
Go right up for that rock fortress and cut up and around it.
Looks so close.
It's so far away. Exhausted.
We're at
like 17,000 feet. We're still front-porting ice climbing and rock climbing. But
not expect to be doing this kind of climbing here at altitude.
Dude, that was heinous. Yeah, that was sick, nice huh? Lead, dude.
No, it didn't even hold a picket.
About 17.2, probably a bit more, maybe 17.3. Summit's 100 feet up or less, maybe right over that cornice right there. We're not sure. But we just hit this terrible unconsolidated snow and we really climbed hard today. You know, we're pretty sure that now's the time to turn around, even though we're so goddamn close. Just don't have much left here. But we gotta get out of here.
Not near as airy as crappy.
Yeah! Yes! Dude, I can't believe we're in third.
Come on, get it on!
Yes!
It's a good country. It feels like there's so much empty space. That's the coolest thing about this country. There's just very few people considering the amount of terrain, so many mountains, and just a sense of openness that you don't get back home.
The scale of things is just massive. Now, I definitely thought, you know, the mountains were a little intimidating at first, a lot of history there. But now we're in a place where there, you know, there's nomadic history, but there isn't much mountaineering history where we're going, so I'm really excited to just get it going.
I mean, the idea of coming all the way to Kyrgyzstan and climbing something that hasn't been climbed is something that was pretty unsettling with everyone, at least at home. I think I had one friend who was really stoked. Everyone else was like, well, it's gonna happen.
It's just so exciting to, you know, turn a corner and see something that no one's ever, a challenge that no one's ever tried to overcome before. And I'm excited to see if we have that in us to make it to the top.
Yeah. So why are we bringing shovels tomorrow?
To tunnel through the cornice.
To dig to China!
Yes, let's dig to China.
This group is definitely special in more than one way. Live together, we've been climbing together, we've learned how to climb together, and we've also learned how to have fun together. So I think that's what makes us special, is we're not just a group of climbers, but we're a group of really good friends and teammates.
The team consisted of Gleesh Bag, J-Lo, Karias, Finn, Stilpers, and Lurbin, previously known as Jorbin, and before that as Turd Burglar. Five of the group lived together in college, the lucky abstention being J-Lo, in a dirtbag's paradise. The fabled 357 Boston Avenue, affectionately referred to as Base Camp, was both a cultural mecca and social experiment, with frequent creative explorations including those concerning hair artwork, meat candles, freeganism, alternative uses for condiments, a pro-corn agenda, and freeform dance. The expedition, successful or not, would at a minimum be an entertaining college reunion.
This is probably the most experienced team I've ever been out with. You can see just by what they're wearing, the way they conduct themselves in the morning.
Who would care to reconduct an interview without dropping sarcasm?
Yeah. Oh, it's like every goddamn time.
Oh my, I can't even pull it out.
I have that pulse back because I was sick.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
After learning that Kyrgyzstan was a country and was full of mountains, we converged on Central Asia with an old Soviet map in hand for our 5-week vacation. Months of Google Hangouts and unanswered questions had led up to our expedition. From Bishkek, the capital, we would travel first to the climbing paradise of Ala-Archa National Park, where shorter alpine climbs would allow us to acclimate and practice our climbing systems as a team. During the Cold War, the peaks of Ala-Archa served as a stout training ground for Soviet mountaineers.
That right because you want to go
yeah
because
yeah and then this is a hut you said or a campsite and this is the that, other time
he's playing a metal shack.
I do believe that it's the things you learned along the way that derive the meaning of the time you spent with people you love in the mountains. It's all about the ladies. That's what we do it for. See those guys over there? They could use some ladies. Day one.
Huh?
You haven't got to go down. I'm just,
yes,
they have. I just don't.
Yeah, you got to go lightweight for those kind of.
Yeah, seriously. We got to slim down.
Just got the neck beard.
Oh my god.
I might become a hair doctor.
The graph.
This is kind of a menacing environment.
Evacuate!
Yeah, that just kind of came out of nowhere.
Kyrgyzstan! Woo! It heard you say we're stopping here, and then I was like, all right, bitches, take this. So, either one, but climbing up there from it'll be fun too.
To a crevasse at the top of this mountain, and so we're just roping up. So we were roped up for crossing these crevasses. And then Zach was about to get on some steep snow / ice, but he sunk into his waist and he heard a crack. And so we all got freaked out about avalanche danger. And so, we're gonna try it again.
Coming back down, it's like, holy shit. Yeah. Had to drop like 25 degrees and like...
Well, it's still bad up there too.
I mean, sun disappears, wind picks up, starts snowing, the mist rolls in.
I should have just turned around right away, but I kept going up it and like about 10 feet later, I just felt the whole thing go crack. Rob heard the crack and then it just settled in.
Jeez.
So,
is that classic?
Dude, kilogram and a half, 2 kilograms. Pure American stool. Oh.
I don't know. I've never like really tried that many pills before. I have Cipro and Diamox. You can try those.
Are those any fun?
I doubt it.
Made it to the hut.
Yeah, what direction is it?
Where do I put it?
Your city?
Yeah.
You got too focused on me.
Probably here so I can just build the logs.
Chicken nervous.
Wheat.
Zach's been super sick at altitude.
I feel like shit.
I just gotta eat it. Much exactly what, like, I think altitude pulmonary edema looks like. Because you're coughing up pink phlegm and mucus.
Uh-huh. How's it taste?
It actually tastes really good.
It's just sugar water. Oh, God.
Then they can just leave it in place for the whole second rope team.
That's really smart. If you really want to move. Mm-hmm. Because it does look pretty crevassy after that second hump.
We'll just get up at 2 and then
yeah.
Do it quick. Just move. You just pack up tonight. That way you just have to put your shit on and go. Yeah.
Awesome. Started out at 3,900 meters. At 340 this morning. Now 5. And we're at 4,250. So by my calculations, we are approaching the speed of light.
Expecting, mm-hmm. But it's awesome.
And I give up.
We're out here, and there's no one else out here. It's pretty stellar. Some big old mountains, some big old vistas.
Corona.
Fuck off.
This is so sweet.
I if that's a Kyrgyz word.
Thank
you. Yeah, it's sweet. Bivy.
Yeah, I think we should call it a night.
Quick game of settlers. The emerge.
Doing awesome, man. You are doing awesome.
Seems like we're feeling the easy way down.
Returning from Ala-Archa, we would buy provisions in Bishkek for our main objective, peak 5318. We would travel east by bus and a rickety four-wheel drive van to Mita Idir Air Base in the Tien Shen Mountains, near the border of China. With good weather, we would be delivered in an old Soviet helicopter to the Djangart River and the base of the valley of Point 5318.
We're in the Osh Bazaar, haggling with the locals. Got a barter with the gypsies. Getting kilos and kilos of nuts and candy.
The seeds. Who shall be the bearer of the seeds?
Actually,
bearer of the bad seeds.
Oh, I don't think it is seeds.
Never. Oh shit. That's a real snow tiger move.
Snow tiger.
That would be sweet if he was like.
I was spilling my brains out last night.
A little meatloaf too. It's like drinking in your living room. Your living room is like a movie. And all screens.
Is it pure monkey bread?
Really
fine. Pure.
Yeah. Kind of cool job. Crash and throw those rocks.
That'd probably be interesting for like an hour.
Спасибо.
Сейчас,
Я пешком здесь, может быть, или здесь.
Вот на эту высоту и на эту, да? Борт до сюда, да? Вертолет.
Да, да.
Вот сюда подбрось. То есть сюда.
Да, да.
What happened was some dude died in the mountains, and so our helicopter is going to be delayed. It's either going to come later today or maybe at all today. We're not sure.
Not regulation size.
Like full.
Yes, Jill.
Oh my god!
6 for 6!
Annihilated!
I can't get it out.
Annihilated!
I don't give a shit anymore. Clearly not.
That's obvious.
Hold on a second.
No, drop the dome.
Hold on a second.
Alright, I'm watching him. Alright, he's around the corner.
Oh no, 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 no.
I see.
No, 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 no.
I saw it. I saw it, Karias. Pat him down. Pat him down.
Oh, he's got dome! He's got dome! Dome! He's got dome! See what we found on your person?
Still covered in feces. I can smell you. You smell like a horse's butthole. You can establish dominance and make the helicopter come sooner.
No. The helicopter comes. We storm the gates. We storm the gates.
We take the base.
Like, there's fuck all we can do. So we can chat about it, which is kind of fun.
telling my great-great-grandchildren the time that we killed 7 liters of sweet, salty blood in a day and a half.
Nope, trying that hard.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not an emotional guy, but that.
I get choked up.
Nothing about that.
We gotta get out of here soon. These guys are throwing shit at each other. They're running around half naked throwing shit at each other.
Horseshit in the kitchen.
That's definitely gonna be my dad.
It could be.
He has like Google.
Hey, finally! Again!
Good luck, you guys. Have a great time.
Yeah,
make sure. Pass on there? Yeah, but it's way west of where we
want to
be.
Okay, but you showed them where it was in relation. Yeah, see those little kids get blown over.
Came here with plenty of vodka, now not so much.
Right here's good.
At least in my dream, my marmacol was like really, really good.
Like here.
It was like that.
Feeling pretty stoked that we're at 13.3 right now. We're up in the wilds of the Tien Shen Djangart region. Getting our first good look at 0.5318. She looks pretty sexy. Pretty intimidating, not gonna lie. Some of those snow slopes are looking more like ice falls. Just stoked to be up here, feeling more and more remote, and it feels good.
We climbed three pretty tough pitches of ice with heavy packs on, with a couple good narrow, kind of mixed sections that bulged out and got a little steep.
This low angle ice is hard work right here, but awesome.
And then found ourselves right, you know, on a rock ridge that connected to a hanging glacier that was just kind of falling apart, a little torn up, and we decided to go for it.
I'm gonna go barehanded, crampons on. I wish we weren't carrying a day and a half's worth of food and fuel and camping equipment.
Glaciers are one of those times where you can get very compact ice that has crazy features. What I loved is you had to live in the moment, and not think about it, anything else. It was like totally pure because you couldn't hesitate a minute. And I did wondering, I hesitated a little wondering which way to go, left or right under this death block, but you know, we made the right choice, definitely cutting right and getting out from under that thing as fast as we could.
So we came up in the middle of the Hanging Glacier about midday. Pretty crazy leads, awesome route so far, but now I think it's Ryan's turn. Do what he's born to do. Get us the hell out of here. Crevasses. I think the fifth class belay to belay with some crawling, all crawling in between. We're gonna crawl our way out of here.
You know, I was super impressed with the way Ryan decided to, you know, just find his own way through a massive crevasse. I think in the end it was the safest way to go versus trying to end run this glacier that could collapse at probably any minute in the heat of the day. So
your tent platform is ready, sir.
We had a wild day going through some crazy stuff, and now we're just camped out in the middle of a glacier with I don't know, it's a decent view.
We've arrived at a new location. Thank you for all your support.
J-Lo and I decided to spend another night at this just fantastic bed and breakfast that we found. They're a little light on the breakfasts, but their presentation is unbelievable, you know? Just a hall's breeze between each course of a small block of cheese, sausage, half a Clif Bar for dinner. But you really can't beat the views.
We're gonna take off and fly down this narrow constriction and try to shortcut our way out of here, hopping over a serac, under this loose rock here, and find our way home and have multiple meals and dinners waiting for us. This way might have been harder than we thought. That is crazy, dude. This mountain is just the coolest.
It's freaking awesome. Like
just a last little.
Hungry much?
There it is. Right there.
Now I gotta see your face when you open up this.
Wait, there's more? What is that? Is that an apple crumble or something? Ah! I didn't even, how did you, you didn't tell me about this? Look at that, just waiting for us here at home. Oh, welcome back to base camp. That's fucking kids. How's the descent coming along? Can't wait to see you guys. Thanks again. You're amazing.
You too, sweetheart.
Yeah. Little jaunt. How you going, man? Hello. Hello. How are you guys?
Fucking sweet little day.
Hey, you guys.
Stilpers.
Because it's difficult to tell the difference between like 100 shit molecules and like a million shit molecules.
Yeah, I mean, that's the danger. You have to make it really homogenous.
Yeah, so I mean, that's why it's good we have like two.
Otherwise, you can just keep diluting the same turd into the delusion.
I think it's all right, though.
I don't know what part of the horse
it's
they put
okay
on it, but
onions.
Let's do it.
It'd be delicious.
See? Quality Kazakh product.
Well, it's not going to be any worse than the chicken. There probably hopefully won't be any horse bones like there were chicken bones.
Salt?
From where Nick and I from out there, it looked pretty steep. Looked like we would want to V-thread it.
Four peak to the summit, and then you got that slog to the summit that's going to be killer. We'll just have to go as fast as I can, breaking that trail. Get on that ridge and then rope up for like the cornest craziness that might be up there.
Yeah,
cracking off.
Three oh five.
going for it. A little bit windy, but the stars are out. So hopefully it'll clear up and calm down.
Yeah.
It's a long time in that face.
No, it didn't even hold a picket.
You know, we're pretty sure that now's the time to turn around, even though we're so goddamn close. Just don't have much left here.
We got to the top and it was just unconsolidated styrofoam snow. So I tried digging through it, got about 20 feet in like 20 minutes, just said f*** it, and we wrapped down.
Very rewarding, you know, at least something for next time, I guess. Came so close, but I mean, we did everything we could, and that feels great.
That tiny little rectangle scooted up to that, like, fermented tadpole-shaped rock.
Right, because we wrapped straight out.
And so, we had all that. We didn't stand a f***ing chance. I feel so much better.
200 vertical feet, but yeah. A lifetime away from the summit.
Yeah. We're sitting at 13. Energy is, you know, we got to stretch as much food as possible. And so personally, it's a big objective, but I think it's within our realms. And I'm excited to, more than anything, be out here with the guys.
That's just an arbitrary degree.
Arbitrary 60 degrees.
That's another Samsy bet we have on the line.
It cut diagonally between you.
Yeah, some of that ice you just hear it go.
Our goal for tonight is getting up there, hopefully by dawn. Because it's probably going to be some hard work getting across that ridge. I don't know whether it's going to be just digging through more unconsolidated snow or more hard mixed stuff, but I guess we'll see tomorrow. If we get the mountain, we get the mountain, but all in all, it's a great trip. And that's what I came for.
I'll go up, put you on belay, bring you up.
Okay.
Stolp, if you could toss a line to Austin, he can rope in, we'll all be on belay and on our way. Woo! Oh my god.
Yeah, Robbie!
Oh. Cold.
No, buddy, too.
So, nice half hour.
So, tits off.
You know, put lines on. Let me get over here. I'll put them on, you can get off our rope.
Thank you.
I think. Feels wild. Feels amazing. It's definitely the coolest experience of my life.
So much hard work paid off.
You look great, Jayla.
I love you.
I love you too. Getting down to be scared.
Want some water?
Eventually summited, just caught me by surprise. It was a little scary getting up there and getting down, but it was amazing.
I don't know, well at the time I guess it hadn't really hit me. I was still kind of preoccupied with getting down. But yeah, right now that I've had some time to think about it, it's pretty unreal.
This is a climb pretty much unlike any I've ever done, I'd say, dude. It's just wild to pick a place in the world and do everything you got to do to get there, and just this one point way up high and all of a sudden you're standing on it. At least we know we've given it everything we've got out here with the time that we have, and you know, time is so limited. I'm glad I can spend it with these guys.
Yeah, amazing. We couldn't have gotten better weather. We're gonna have to embellish when we talk about the weather, so otherwise it's just too easy. Make Bloody Marys, like tomato paste and vodka.
And like some of that garlic powder and stuff.
Yeah, garlic powder, a little. Do we have any lemon drink left? Because that could be like the lemon.
No.
Yeah. We don't have any Worcestershire, but we have some pretty spicy shrubs.
We have garbanzo beans.
Spicy shrubs.
That's interchangeable for what?
Celery? Oh, that's, dude, we should be soaking garbanzo beans right now.
What about the powdered celery?
First sip.
Hold on, wait. Let me get it ready for you.
No, you.
Let me get it ready for you.
You son of a bitch.
Oh, yes.
Oh, it's water. We got you good.
The department's got us. Oh, he likes it.
Oh, I like it. I like it a lot, yes.
Plan. Basically just not eating so you can get drunker. It's very spiritual.
No. Yeah, here throwing up a sheen because you're wasting alcohol.
And calories.
That's some serious calories.
Yeah. You, if you throw up, if anyone throws up, they have to eat it immediately.
Oh, I spritz you.
See?
It's sealed. No.
Just
Don't.
Okay.
Look at Zach. Yo, save them the rest of us, Mr. Big Boobs.
It's not flammable.
Wait, no, Chris, keep it. Raise it.
Rob's lately being like a real big dick, like a huge, enormous asshole. He's been finishing his sentences with, you son of a bitch, which is, you know, not pleasant on the ears. It really, like, makes me feel bad.
Is that son of a bitch talking about me?
I'm out of here.
Cool.